Nick over here from Papa 11. We're talking to Jeri Ellsworth. She's come all the way from Seattle, Washington.
Portland, Oregon,
yes. Very far out, so literally people come all around the world, all around America to get to play pinball.
Definitely.
What do you think of Papa here, Jeri?
This is the best tournament around because you have like 300 or more pinball machines to play all different vintages, stuff that's, you know, the old 30s and 40s wood rails to modern solid state machines with non-matrix display.
Now, when did you first start getting into pinball?
I got into pinball because I worked in a bowling alley cleaning the index at the bowling alley, and the owner of this place had an 8-ball deluxe that was like his private machine, and he would sit there and beat on the thing, and I would watch him play this thing. I was probably 12 years old or so, and he would occasionally wrap up some credits on it and he'd give them to me. And at first I really wasn't into it, but then later, after watching him play and seeing that there was skill involved, that's how I got into pinball. I really started enjoying pinball.
So what were the first games that you started playing?
8-Ball Deluxe, Pinbot, Adam's Family, those are the ones that stand out the most from my childhood.
So how you been doing today in the tournament so far, the whole weekend?
I think I'm at like 15th place out of 100 something.
In A division.
Yeah, the A division.
Compared to me with C division.
I'm not going to make it, but that's fine.
Now, Jeri also, not only is she a great pinball player, but she's also a hacker.
Did you
come up with a different unique way? So tell the folks at home what you came up with. This is amazing.
Well, I'm probably best known for the Commodore 64 joystick. It's a joystick that has 30 built-in Commodore 64 games, and it's an actual Commodore 64. I reverse engineered the C64 and shrunk it down to a single chip, so you could play all these games. And what made it very special was I tricked the manufacturers into putting little test points on the circuit board so you could open the device up, solder connections onto it, hook a disk drive, hook a keyboard, and other peripherals to it. And you could flash your own games into it, and it was a real Commodore 64 at that point.
So what gave you that idea? You just saw it, you looked at the inside and said, you know, I can do this, make it smaller, do something different.
Well, I used to have a chain of retail computer stores in the 90s, and those were failing and not doing well. This was around 2000. So I decided to close down most of the stores and sell them off. And so I'm like, well, what am I going to do next? And I decided I wanted to do chip design. And at this point, FPGAs, these programmable chips, became reachable for like the hobbyist market. So I bought some FPGAs, these chip emulator, best word for them, I guess, and started working on reverse engineering the C64. But I thought the C64 would be a perfect thing to put into an FPGA because it gives you sound, graphics, input-output, just all these things that you need to do when you're doing chip design. And plus, C64 was my first computer, and it was really my love. And I spent a lot of time on a C64 when I was like...
Yeah, I had an Atari 400, all I used it was to play Popeye.
Atari?
I'm sorry.
I can't talk to you anymore.
So, this is a question that I love to ask people. If I stranded you on a deserted island and I said you could have any three pinball machines you wanted, which one would you pick and want?
I'd have to take the Black Knight 2000 because it has a really entertaining music scheme for it. Plus it has a diamond.